We were on a routine bombing run outside Cairo. Orders were to bomb. Our target was a Qatarist colony. They'd taken over a refinery. It was a well-armed facility protecting them from the dead they worshipped. Top priority was to cut off their comms and leave them in the dark.
Yeah.
But first, we had to clear out their defenses. This was a routine sweep. Every time another sympathizer colonist brought it up, we'd squash it back down. As far as we were concerned, we were doing the world a favor. We moved on the array, but the undead sympathizers weren't going down without a fight.
See ya! I'm up here, dude. Yeah. Damn it, I need a building, mate.
Disabling the comms would take some time.
Camera's back.
Our support detail dealt with that. I dealt with reinforcements.
Thank you. Oh, yes. I can see you.
The station disabled, we had to get back to our berth. The station disabled, we had to get back to our bird. The array was ahead. To bring it down, we'd be one step closer to eradicating this colony.
Down.
Our support detail needed a few moments to disable the array. Lucky for me, I had more hostiles to keep me occupied.
You have? Yes.
Disabling the comms would take some time. Our support detail dealt with that. I dealt with reinforcements.
I got my gun still.
Thank you.
die, bitch.
Hendrix had pulled all the data he could. I hoped it was enough. Our pickup was in position. It's time to get the hell out of here.
Uh-huh.
Our bird wasn't alone in the sky. Our VTOL had caught the attention of an old automated place. We needed to find another way.
Come up here, dude!
This Wraith telling you. It was like the malfunctioning robot you found in different quarantine zones. The one targeting anything and everything is an enemy.
Just like that. Except on a much larger, more deadly scale. And this one was very interested in us. Command had an exit route. Extraction set beyond the swamps. If we crossed the super trees, there were shipping docks where we could commandeer an airboat. It's easier said than done.
What I'm trying to do is I'm trying to stay. Oh, ooh, who's that?
Between the flesh eaters and that wraith eyeing us, the super trees would be no walk in the park. We had to haul ass and stay out of sight. But they weren't our only concern. Winslow Accord picked up chatter ahead. Apparently, we weren't the only humans using the docks to escape.
Fucking die, you fucking bitch! No! Why not? I'm too fucked.
Chatter confirmed the 54 immortals were scrambling to get out of biodomes through the swamps.
coming!
Look like we were jumping from one bad situation into another.
Yep, you have.
Between the flesh eaters and the
this bishop that Moretti mentioned.
Damien Bishop, 6115 victims, human again.
A cure? Did it work?
It should have. Something was blocking it. Bishop had this theory. He believed somewhere there was an undead brain. A single creature controlling them as a collective hive. He believed that it somehow blocked the cure. We met him in 2065 when he made the breakthrough. News traveled fast. He and a few others were kidnapped in Ethiopia. It was a joint op with Taylor's team. We were to extract Bishop from a base overrun by the dead.
Yeah, that's fun, yeah. You know what,
with the dead crawling all over, we needed a distraction. Something to keep the flesh eaters occupied so we could grab Bishop. We weren't dead killers yet, so we had to be a little more creative. And lucky for us, there were plenty of NRC birds in the sky, and the NRC's dead system still worked. Laser cannons built to auto-target any hostile aircraft.
So you created the diversion.
And Taylor's team prepped extraction. Unfortunately, it seemed our cover wouldn't last as long as we hoped. The remaining NRC noticed the radio silence from air traffic control and had sent soldiers to investigate. Command set exfil for a satellite station off base. We reset the dead system to target one of the automated planes circling above. Turns out the undead have a thing for giant explosions. Like moths drawn to a porch lamp. And all we had to do was turn on the lights. Unfortunately, we couldn't exactly control the landing. Hendricks alerted Taylor the bird was down and the diversion in play. We took out the NRC and moved. Bishop was being held underground in the security station across the tarmac. Hendricks ordered weapons down. The base was crawling with NRC soldiers and undead. No need to draw any more attention to ourselves. We crossed the tarmac. The tunnel ahead led to the security station.
I'll be deaf. I'll be deaf, but I won't be knackered. Because I can't read.
Hendricks took out the guards. I hacked into the system to find Bishop.
Why were the NRC still at the base? It was being overrun.
They needed the cure. They kidnapped Bishop's whole team and would do whatever it took to get their hands on it.
Didn't get this far.
They'd torture these researchers till the dead broke down the door and ripped them all to shreds if it meant they could save their people. It wasn't personal. It was self-preservation. With the secret out about Bishop's discovery, he'd become the most wanted man in the world. The NRC were just the first to grab him. It was every country for itself. Why do you think we were there? The Winslow Accord wanted the same thing the NRC did.
You can't rationalize anything when you're put up against the wall.
Nothing about this was rational. It was instinctual, animalistic, survival.
Yeah, playing the game. Oh, fuck me! Oh my god! Down again. Got down. I got, they came up behind me.
He had been escorted to an interrogation room. We had to hurry. Behind us was an undead army. Once one got a whiff, the others would come running.
Save your bacon there, dude.
Not here now.
He's not. Oh my days.
Hendricks told Bishop who we were and that we had to move, but Bishop refused to leave without the other researchers, his friends. Our concern, Winslow Accord pit shatter. We had to haul ass and stay out of sight. But they weren't our only concern. Winslow Accord picked up chatter ahead. Apparently, we weren't the only humans using the docks to escape.
Oh, well, thanks, dude. Dude. got to jump this.
Super tree was collapsing. The only safe route to the docks was up. Chatter confirmed the 54 immortals were scrambling to get out of the biodomes through the swamps.
I'm about to run. Easy. Oh, there's only one boat.
Sound of it, they wanted us dead as much as the Flesh Eaters did. Looked like we were jumping from one bad situation into another.
Remember this one?
Hendrix commandeered an airboat and set the autopilot. We had undead on our ass, and more 54i ahead. And that rogue Wraith wasn't done with us yet. Virus. 6115 wouldn't stop this time. The Winslow Accord and CDP had been thrown into chaos. We'd lost Hong Kong, Berlin, and Cairo, and it was just getting started. What would come next? How the world would change? There was no way to be ready.
We'll land somewhere.
Yeah, sure.
5 years. 5 long, dark years. Opening the quarantine zones did exactly as we feared. And by 2075, what was a contained situation gave way to anarchy. Humanity's numbers had been reduced to a few hundred mil scattered across the globe. The undead had risen to 7 billion. Taylor
fucking die!
A faded reminder of our inability to stop Armageddon. There was still a Winslow.